Hello friends, welcome back to our online course on refrigeration and air conditioning. In last lecture we have completed this OA. This OA is nothing but what? Sensible heating. In this lecture we will complete sensible cooling. Now what is sensible cooling? It is nothing but the cooling of air without change in its humidity or specific humidity or humidity ratio. It is similar to the sensible heating, only here instead of heating we are moving towards the, or we are going for the cooling process. Now here also once again take the same thing, we are having air which is at a temperature TD1, and here the same air is living at temperature TD2. Here this is nothing but the cooling coil, or we can say it as a refrigerant which is passed through these coils which is at temperature T3. Now here what is there? There is a temperature difference between this TD1 and TD3. Means here TD1 is greater than T3. In heating it was opposite. Now here as this TD1 is greater than T3, what will happen? The heat transfer from the coils inside which we are going to have the flow of refrigerant, from that place heat is transferred towards the TD1. As a result of that I can have the greater value of TD2. Now same process, this sensible cooling, how we can plot on this psychometric chart. This x-axis represents the dryable temperature in degree Celsius. This is nothing but the relative humidity or specific humidity or humidity ratio. Now let us say this is nothing but your point number one. 1 to, during 1 to 2 process what is happening? Cooling is happening. As a result of that this temperature is TD1 and this temperature is nothing but TD2. And finally here I am having temperature T3. As a result of temperature difference between point number 1 and point number 3, heat transfer will take place. As a result of that we are getting point number 2, or we can get temperature TD2. Now as a result of this sensible cooling, what I am having? As a result of that sensible cooling process, the temperature goes on decreasing. If I will compare the temperature of point number 1 and point number 2, easily I can say that temperature goes on decreasing. Now similar to temperature, what will happen to this specific humidity, humidity ratio or humidity? What will happen as that heat, cooling process goes on, that the specific humidity remains constant. Then what will happen to the relative humidity? As I am going for the cooling, we are knowing that in this direction the relative humidity goes on increasing. And now what will happen to the enthalpy? That enthalpy also goes on decreasing. Once again I will revise, during sensible cooling process the temperature goes on decreasing. By keeping the humidity constant, the relative humidity goes on increasing and enthalpy goes on decreasing. Now how we can calculate the amount of heat rejected? Similar to the sensible heating process, I can write Q is equal to H1 minus H2, or I can write Q is equal to 1.022 into bracket TD1 minus TD2. TD1 and TD2 are nothing but what? The air inlet temperature and air outlet temperature. Thank you.
Hopefully you might have enjoyed the lecture. Then please do like the video and know your thoughts in comments. Please do share this video among your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. After subscription, you can press the bell icon to never miss the notification regarding our new videos. Thank you so much.